वेलकम टू IELTS Ninja।
Now that my essay flow is at hand, let us look at the sample passage. So, as I told you, the first introductory paragraph in a sample passage should consist of three things. One, an opening statement, then an overview statement, and a thesis statement. So, if you read my first paragraph, environmental issues are a concern for almost everyone today. As we see the natural world suffering increasing damage from pollution, construction, and other human activity. However, to say that governments should regard this one issue as their main priority might be rather simplistic. In this essay, I hope to establish the futility of concentrating only on the environmental challenges without considering the effects of other issues such as overpopulation. So, especially the last sentence here is going to give the examiner an idea about what are the various things I'm going to be talking about in this essay. Now, let us come to the second paragraph. Admittedly, it is correct that environmental protection should be among our greatest concerns. Because this is my first main point, I have declared it in the first sentence itself. Now, my supporting statement is, without coordinated measures from national and global organizations, the environment will continue to deteriorate, leading to a more unstable world for us all. For example, in the last few years alone, we have faced a range of global environmental challenges, including delayed monsoons, melting of polar caps, etc. However, by focusing on this topic to the exclusion of others, we run the risk of neglecting a range of other equally grave challenges. So here, what have I done in my second paragraph? I have introduced my first main point. I've supported that point, given example of how in today's world, environmental challenges are being faced not just by one country, but all countries together. And hence, this should be a unified effort in overcoming these challenges. But what is my main point of view? My main point of view is that environmental issues are extremely important, but they should not be the only point of concentration, which is why I've introduced the last sentence where I've told, however, by focusing on this topic alone, to the exclusion of others, we run the risk of neglecting a range of other equally grave challenges. So this forms as a connector for my next paragraph, sort of introducing the next paragraph even before it starts. Now, coming to the third paragraph, I'm going to introduce my second main point. Here you can see, written, foremost among these challenges is a question of overpopulation, by which I mean the growth of human numbers beyond the ability of the human race to support itself. Let's take, for instance, the issue of depleting natural resources. This environmental issue stems from the exponential growth of population. If this problem is not addressed, we potentially face the collapse of modern human society and consequently the ability of the human race to combat the environmental damage which has already taken place. Notice how I've split this paragraph. In the first sentence, I introduce my main point. Then I substantiate it with a supporting point or an explanation and an example. I explain this point and given an example with regards to natural reserves and the sort of fast depletion that we are seeing in them. Okay. Now coming to the conclusion of my passage. While concluding this passage, please keep in mind that your conclusion should be in parallel to your initial paragraph and at the same time should review all the key points that you have touched upon. So, this is what my conclusion reads like. Overall, the environment is certainly a major priority. However, it should be seen as one among a range of issues to be solved, and the solutions themselves could lead to better preservation of nature. So this is a direct reiteration of our initial introduction. Next, We must accept the fact that holistic development can only happen when both the ecological and social ecosystems are interlinked. Concentrating only on one of the aspects while ignoring others is futile. So I have reiterated my core point of view in the last conclusion, while summing up the basic trend or the context in which I've written. So what are the things that we can take away from this? First, the introduction must give a basic idea about your essay. Each paragraph must take up one main point, and conclusion should be in parallel to the introduction. Connectors must be used wherever possible, but at the same time, please remember that connectors need to come very naturally. They should not be forced into the essay. The more natural the connectors, the more easy it is going to be to read through the passage. Finally, the vocabulary that you use must be relevant to the topic given. It does not have to be fancy vocabulary or bombastic vocabulary, but all the words that are required to put across your stance in a very easy to understand manner should be there. So that was the end of our masterclass.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, then don't forget to like, comment and share the video. Subscribe to IELTS Ninja and hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Don't forget to register for our free live classes. Find the link in the description box. This is your chance to prepare yourself with personal trainers.